Hi everyone, this is Paulo, and this is my first draft video for Channel Fireball. Since this is the first time I do it, I might make some mistakes, I'm not really used to this, so please forgive me if I do. And as you probably know, English is not my first language, so you might not understand something of what I say, and in that case, just ask in the forums. Okay, so here, I guess the options are Ancient Hawkeye, Pyromancer, Lightning Bolt, Pacifism. Yeah, I don't really like red in this format, so none of the red cards are appealing to me. And Pacifism is just the best of those cards, regardless of color, I think. So that's what I would take. I really like the blue-white deck, and Pacifism goes great in either the control version or the aggro version. So it sounds like my first pick to me. Here there's not much in terms of white. I did not feel like second picking is power charge. I'll just go with the Menelik, which I also think it's a good addition in either the control deck or the aggro deck. And blue white is just my favorite combination, so that's where I want to be anyway. I don't mind like being bound to two colors this early if those are the two colors I actually want to be in. In here, it's either the Cloud Crusader or the Owl. And I think the Cloud Crusader is just a better card. I think the Gravedigger is the best card here. I would go with that if that was the first pick. But I don't think it pairs well with white at all, like the black. So I just take Roller Sovereign and stay on color. I think it's also relevant to note that in any of those packs, you can't really expect to will anything very important. Here it's either the Negate or the Celestial Purge. Both are kind of sideboarded cards, but I think the Negate might be main deck, whereas I'll never main deck Celestial Purge. So I just picked up. We got a Mana Leak. I really like Counterspells in this set, especially Mana Leak and Cancel, and I'll happily play as many of them in the control deck. Here there's Flash Freeze, which is a cyber card. We can see another Yavimaya Worm. Just pick the pass card. It's kind of leaning towards blue white control, which is my favorite archetype. Though the cards I have this far are not really awesome. I'm just never gonna play a Genesis Mantra. So I just pick it after it. You either pick the Charge or the Voshock Berserkers. Maybe hoping to play it. I don't know, this time I'm not really bound to either of those colors, so I might play red, but it's not very likely. And even if I do, I'll probably get a chance to get more Voshock Berserkers later, so I picked the Inspired Charge, which I might play. Yes, this is the card I maybe play. I think Wall of Finds is actually a decent card in the board. I guess the best card here is just Interdept, regardless of the colors we're in. If this was the first pack, I would also pick Interdept. We can probably expect to will something out of that pack. I guess G8 cards would be like this. So we're probably getting in the Gaze or Safe Passage back. Here I just picked a Squadron Hawk. If I got like two of them, they're already better than Asa Griffin, I think. And since this is the beginning of pack 2, I can reasonably expect to, I guess. Now in some decks, Sleep would maybe be better than Pacifism, but this is not one of those decks. This again seems like it leans more on the control end of the spectrum. Even if I have Inspired Charge, I'm probably not gonna play it. And the Sleep would just be bad, not very good. Pacifism is better. Furtive, which I really really like. And we already have two Pacifism and one Adept, so the chance of connecting is not really small. your card to me. Here we got a second Squadron Hawk, which is just better than anything else. I like my deck a lot more now than I did in the first pack, with the two Hawks and the Teeth and the Pacifism. Here, I'm not gonna play Elixir. I'm not gonna play this, so it's either the Siren or the Mighty Leap. I don't think I will play either of them, but at this point, it looks like there is a bigger chance I'll play the Siren than a Mighty Leap. Just do not see myself Mighty Leaping anything. Here, either is Communicate or Ice Cage. I think Excommunicate is the better card. Now I have Unsummon and Ice Cage. I don't like Leyline, the blue Leyline. I've never actually played with it, but it seems pretty bad to me if it's on in your opening hand. So it's either the Unsummon or the Ice Cage. There's some decks Ice Cage is better against, and in some decks you'd rather have Unsummon. I don't really know which one is going to be better in this deck. I will pick the Unsummon, since I already have two Pacifisms, so I don't want them boarding in their Ancient Removal. So we did will both Safe Passage and Negate. And I think the Negate is just a better card, especially since we already have a Safe Passage. Well, now I only need a third Negate, and the guard is actually decent in the control deck, so I'll pick this. At this point, I'm kind of worried about how we're gonna kill our opponents, but I just got better. Yep. Now we can start filtering those cards away. Playing this, I don't think I'm not playing double negate, but I don't actually know how to hide one without hiding the other, so I just keep them both there. Now this is the exact card I wanted to open. I know a lot of people don't like it, but I think it's just really powerful, and since I'm not in the aggro deck, this card is perfect for me. Here it does like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 picks, so I'll probably not will anything, but that's fine. Now there's the other Scrotif and the Blinding Mage, and the Blinding Mage is just better. And this pack is pretty, it's not insanely powerful, but it has a lot of quality cards. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we will two of the decent cards. It'll probably be Glacial Fortress and a Genius Prime Mage. Now this pack is not as good. It's either the Serpent or the Gargoyle. And we're passing a lot of active prisons, but nothing we can do about that. I'm thinking this deck, I kinda want the big guy more than the Sentinel. I don't have a lot of ways to kill them yet, and this kind of kills them. Now Sleep, I'm probably not gonna play Sleep in this deck, but it's the only decent card. It's probably pretty good against me, so. Now in some decks, Honor of the Pure would be excellent. In this deck, there are 5 white guys, I don't really feel like playing it. But I don't feel like playing the Mighty Leap either. So I guess I would just pick the better card. There's still a lot of cards to go, so maybe I find a reason to play Honor of the Pure, but that's very unlikely. If I see a third Hawk, I'll probably play Honor of the Pure. So I'll pick it. Yeah, this is pretty bad. Banshee is by far the best card here. But when I play Mind Leap, I don't know. I think the chance I'll play it is bigger than the chance I'll play against a person who got the Howling Banshee, and they're gonna draw it and win the game because of that. So I'll pick him early. I just take it up while I'm not playing it. Wilson's like a pretty good card. I wish I had a couple of forces. It seems to me like this is what this deck is missing. Oh, so I did not wheel either. Oh wait, is this a different pack? Yeah, never mind. I thought it was a Glacial Fortress pack. It's not. There's no card to play. So we do not wield the Glacial Fortress, instead we wield the Ossa Griffin, which is a better card anyway. In some decks you might want the 2-2 more. That's not very likely, but it could happen, but not in this deck. I'll take the rare. So there are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 white cards. I don't think that's enough to play Honor of the Pure. The curve is actually not high, so I'm fine with 17 lands. I don't think I need to sleep. Like, what am I? I'm gonna sleep and attack with what? Scroll Thief, Weather Servant, Sage Mastodon, that's about it. Doesn't seem worth it to me. And neither does the Elite Vanguard. Though maybe there is a build somewhere with Honor of the Pure, Elite Vanguard, and Sleep. Probably not. I'd rather stay more controlish. I feel like this deck really is missing Forces, Jace Ingenuity. I think it would be decent to good if I had like two of those. As it is, I don't really like it that much, but I don't know. Let's see how it works out. I think there are more blue cards than white cards, and more double cost in blue too. So I'll just play on our island. Yeah, this is what I'm playing. Well, let's see how it works out. Woo!